Okay, I know what you're thinking. Random is random. I don't see the difference. But no, every noise generator has a personality. And I have opinions on this. Let's rank them. Before we look at any chip, though, I want to explain what you're looking at here. I've taken each waveform and plotted each sample value to a pixel brightness. Then I've got that on a perpetual palette cycle. This one is just a sine wave, which isn't quite aligned with the width of the image, but I think you can still see its wavy nature. Right, so let's start with pure random noise, just as a baseline. Did you know that you can download an endless supply of numbers generated from the random fluctuations of atmospheric noise? This is as purely random as it gets. And listening to it kind of sucks. F tier. Do better, universe. Next, the venerable sound generator of the original Nintendo Entertainment System. We have 16 possible playback rates and 16 volume levels, so we can get musical in here. The highest frequencies are pretty good for hi-hats. The mids make for great snares. The lows, well, they're passable. But you have the option to choose between random noise or periodic noise. And the periodic noise has a delightful metallic twang to it. This can be used to beefen your snares or accent your hi-hats. The bass is a little better, but noise gens are always going to be a little weak here. I'm personally fond of the 16 playback rates, but I do recognize that this can be a limiting factor, so B tier. The Game Boy is kind of like the next step above the NES. It has a far broader range of playback rates, so all the advantages there apply here, but with more nuance. There's a subtle tonality to it that I personally enjoy. The short loop is kind of wild. You got a whole F minor chord in here, if 25 cents flat. Otherwise, yeah, it's just an NES, but a little bit better. A tier. Next in our Nintendo lineage is the SNES. It's not exactly an upgrade from the previous two chips. In fact, it's a sampler first and foremost. But it does have a noise generator with 32 possible values. Half of those are so low that they're useless. Seriously, look at this waveform. I do have to commend the middle range sounds, though. They've got a nice crunch to them. That, plus the very usable high end. I'm gonna put this in C tier. The Wonder Swan. This one's a bit odd, but importantly for our purposes, it has a selectable noise length. The first one just sounds like noise. The second one sounds like looped noise. After that, it's just tones. Interestingly, you can see how the pseudo-random number generators work by looking at these patterns. As you scroll down, the loops get shorter. This is a really cool little system. The lows are a bit more navigable thanks to the multiple length options. The mids are okay, and the highs are good. I'm gonna put this in B tier. The Tia from the Atari 2600. You can feel the 70s oil crisis when you use this thing. Two channels and 16 waveforms. Kind of. One of them is a burst of random noise on loop, but it's short. On the higher ranges, it loops and you can feel it. The middle range is fine as long as you want a short burst of noise, which you probably do for percussion. And low range is just, it's pretty rough. D tier. The Pokey is kind of like if the Tia was actually usable. I don't fully understand it, but I'm highlighting two waveforms. Number 0 on the left, which I'm calling harsh noise, and number 4 on the right, which I'm calling soft noise. There's some additional bits you can set to change their ranges, but I'm ignoring those. But even ignoring those, these have a huge range and some great textures. If it were just a soft noise, I'd complain that it's a little weak in the mid and low ranges, but the harsh noise excels at both. The soft noise is great at higher pitches and it's with its fuller spectrum, and the harsh noise has a sort of squariness that makes it beg to be used for a snare. I've got to give this one an A tier. The Lynx is a weird beast. Atari really said, what if we replaced all of the tone generators with noise generators? And then most people just use those to make square waves anyway. To be fair, there are 512 possible options and none of them are in tune. And some of them are just random noise. I'm going with option number 509, which is a pretty long length of random noise. And it's pretty good. There's an additional bit that you can set that kind of softens this noise, which is what you've been looking at here. It does this by kind of like wave shaping the waveform, it looks like, but in a way to soften it rather than add harmonics. And I love it, especially for the mid-range frequencies. Combine this with the other 511 options and yeah, of course, the all noise generator chip would be the king of noise generation. This is the only one going into S tier. Deserves it. The AY38910. This thing is a beast of a chip thanks to its envelope feature, but we're just here for the noise. And with 32 frequencies, the noise is kind of non-existent at the low end. The high end is great though. The middle range, which is to say the lowest possible value that the chip allows, has this nice crunch to it as well. But there's a secret weapon here. You can set the channel to play a noise and tone at the same time. It's basically free ring modulation, and this rules as a sound design tool. But it's still limited by that small noise range. This is still a great feature that I wish more chips had. B tier overall. The SN76. There are more numbers to that, but I think the first two are enough. This is a pretty sad chip, I've got to say. No bass. You have three options for the noise frequency. This makes it easy to pick a frequency for the kick, snare, and hi-hat, but let's be real, it's not great. You could sacrifice one of your three square channels to unlock a full range of noise, but even then, the noise generation has this weird tinny sound to it. I'm not even sure how to describe it. The entire chip is just stuck sounding cute. There's technically a periodic noise option as well, but in practice, it's just a very thin pulse wave. I think it's purely there so you have a non-square wave option for your melodies. D tier. At least it has some options, I guess. The VIC-20 is wild. Like, why does it sound like that? The noise channel is unlike anything else I've ever heard. The highest frequencies are a perfect match for a leak in a pressurized chamber. And then when you go lower, it's like everything is generated with FM synthesis. It kind of rules. This might actually be the best at low frequencies. But naturally, the mid is what I loved most. That snare has body. A tier. The Commodore 64, a cult classic of a computer with some of the craziest composers still using it 40 odd years later. And the noise generation on this thing? Sorry, but it's kind of weak. It really sounds like blowing through a straw. It's serviceable, but it's just not, it's not great. However, it is a noise generator attached to the SID. And that thing has filters and a bunch of other features that I don't fully understand. And those work miracles with that noise channel. But beneath that, it's still the straw, so I'm going to average it out with a B tier. And that's every chip I could think of off the top of my head. So what do you think? Was I too harsh? Did I miss your favorite noise? Let me know in the comments, and I'll see you next time.